It's 7 a.m. in the morning, and I got about 5 hours of sleep, and I don't know what up? It's 7 a.m. in the morning, and I got about 5 hours of sleep, and I don't know what to do. I don't have class till like 2:30 p.m. today. One of those nights, man. It's like it always gets you thinking, those restless nights where your mind just wander. And me, I was thinking about some old times, some old past, you know, and just like, man, it's just insane and a lot of crazy shit. Have you guys ever had one of those nights where you can't sleep and you're just tossing and turning and just like, just can't? So that's me. That's me today, this morning. So I'm probably just gonna stay up, do some video editing. If not, I only gotta wait like 30 minutes until I can go get breakfast. Yeah, breakfast. I wonder if it's make your omelet day today.
I haven't did a vlog or anything in a while since I got back here to IAIA. I've been busy. Busy. I decided to take only 12 credits this semester. I didn't get my job back. I choose not to get my job back. I just wanted to take a break because the past two semesters, well, for the last year, I've been working really hard. I've been taking about 18 credit hours and working over 20 hours a week, and that's not including all the video projects that I was doing on the weekends. So I was literally only getting about maybe 6 hours of sleep every night for the last past year, for the past two semesters. So this semester I decided to take a break, take it easy before I burn myself out again. And I think that's the reason why I haven't did a lot of vlogs, is because I put all my time and energy into producing films and working on other projects. And I think that will be the subject for today, is taking it easy and not burning yourself out. Like, that's a real thing, and I experienced it big time. I just been doing some bead work. I haven't did any bead work, and my wall is like getting crazy filled up there. Like, yeah. So topic today is taking it easy. That is definitely the topic for today. Taking it easy and planning out stuff, what to do, like, because if you don't take it easy and pay attention on your health, it's gonna take an effect on you, and you're gonna feel drowsy, you're gonna feel restless, you're gonna feel like you don't want to do anything. That was me, and I think I am still trying to make the transition into taking it easy. Yeah, I still, like, since I've been back, I've been trying to get out of that funk of just, like, always on the go, always running, always doing something, always have to try to be doing something. That's me. Like, ever since I was growing up, I always had to be doing something. Like, this is somewhat of the first time of not doing a lot of things, if that makes sense, somewhat. What am I taking? God, I can't remember. And I've been here for about almost a month now. Okay, first class I'm taking is Moving Image 3. That is pretty much like a junior class. It's where you create a script, you do your read, you do your location scouting, you create your crew, you film, you edit, post-production, and you create a film, pretty much. That's all in Moving Image 3 that I'm taking. The second class that I am taking is a jewelry making class, so silver work. You're working with silver, and that's an intro class I'm taking. And I've been doing jewelry for like, since the age of 6. And I decided just to take that, just to, you know, see if I still got it. Third class, I am taking advanced tutorial project. So pretty much you're just helping the seniors class project, senior one and senior two classes. You're helping them with their projects, so anywhere they need help, like a gaffer, a crew, a best boy, electrician boy, all that kind of stuff, you're pretty much going on their crew to help them, anything from shooting behind the camera, in front of the camera, or editing. So that's that class. So that's the third one. Fourth one that I am taking, don't spherical dome. So pretty much you're working with the dome. And what's crazy about the dome here is that no one had did the class for 3 years. They haven't offered it for 3 years, and this is the first time bringing it back since we have a new dome teacher. Learning process, and it's that, I think that's the class that's given me more of a hard time and to think, because I'm so used to shooting in a square format or a rectangle format, like how we do in our vlog. But in dome, we shoot in a circle. So a circle format, and to create that, change the rules for everything. You know, you don't have your rule of thirds, your 180, where's your action line, how to transition, and to create, like, transition's easy. Like, you can make in a regular format, like me walking in. Okay, let's see. So coming in like that, and it's easy. So with the regular format, you can do stuff like that. It's really easy to transition, but with the circle, it's kind of hard, kind of thinking. And I think that's what's troubling me about that class. It gets you thinking outside the box and what to do. Not working, I didn't get my job at the checkout room. I choose not to, because I was working 20 hours a week, and plus all the other classes I was taking, it burned me out big time, man. Burning out is not a great feeling, and I was only getting about 6 hours of sleep, like I mentioned before, and I know it started taking effect on me. On the go, like on the run, like running and gunning and constantly shooting and working on different projects, and I noticed that my health was taking effect. I knew I wasn't getting sleep. I knew I was just eating a lot of fast food, and I knew I was getting to summer. I decided to try to change all that. So I've been starting to run every day. I've been doing it for about 2 months now, 2.5 months. I try to go for a run, try to get out there, get some fresh air, go and run. I've been eating healthier, no more fast food. Yeah, so those been changing up my lifestyle. Stop spending money, like getting haircuts. I decided just to let my hair grow out. So over the summer, I like buzz cut my hair. Like it was like super, super low. I buzz cut it, and I decided, you know, I'm just gonna let it grow out. I always had long hair. Another thing I noticed, I cut out pop. All the sugary drinks, I stopped drinking all that and been drinking a lot of water. Been eating a lot more fruits. So I noticed I've been losing weight, which feels great, because when you lose weight, like, it's an amazing feeling. I don't know about you, I get excited, because a lot of the clothes that I couldn't wear or were super tight on me, they're loose. Like pants wise and everything, they're like super loose on me, and I didn't have to wear a belt now. Another thing is I get to wear different clothes. Like, hell yeah, I get the fit in my clothes. Like, looking good. The thing I want to do is try to get back into dancing. I seen a post on Facebook, and it was some deep, it was a deep talk. Like, it was, I guess it was a poem someone wrote, and it talked about dancers. And I liked it because this poem, it connected to people in dance. You know, I dance powwow. Like, I'm Northern traditional, and I used to dance fancy when I was younger. And that's how I grew up. Like, I grew up dancing everywhere. It took me around the world, literally around the world. But back to the poem, it's just like, it hit me like right here, like, ooh, like, oh, like, speak to me. It talked about dancers, like, you know, for whatever reason, if you lost, you get burnt out, you lost it, or action injuries or stuff, you know, there, no matter what, dancing is always gonna be there. It's depending when your time is right, when you're gonna come back. And for me, I haven't danced since like 2012. That's when I had my first accident. It was at a contest powwow, Hunting Moon powwow. And I was dancing. It was the second song. It felt like something stabbed me in the back, like really, really bad, and I couldn't breathe. And that was the first time ever, 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 ever had an experience like that. And me, I'm the type of person that pushed myself, which brings back to taking it easy. This is a long age, like
a long topic for me. Just try to take it easy. It's never easy for me taking it easy. So back to the story is that I pushed myself dancing, and we had a third song. The third song, I kept on dancing, pushing myself even more, and I couldn't breathe. I was only taking in about 10% of oxygen, and when I tried to take a deep breath, like, I couldn't do that. It felt like every time I take a deep breath, like someone's stabbing me in my lower back, and it hurts. And when I was dancing out there, I was like breathing like that, and that wasn't good for me. And I started getting dizzy, and I started like going in and out when I was dancing, but I kept on pushing myself like I wasn't gonna faint. And so we had to go line up for contest, and I ran up there, and I was still breathing like that for the whole song and line up until I just had to gasp for air, and I gasped for air, and it some more, and it hurts. Until I got back where we're sitting at, and I literally collapsed down to my knees, and I went like this onto the folding chair. And you know, at the time, my family members thought I was just like resting, trying to catch my breath, but they didn't know I blacked out, and that's how bad it was. And ever since that, I couldn't dance the same, and that hurts. Like, for someone who danced a lot, that's like taking everything away from you. Especially when you grew up with it. It's that bad. So I stopped dancing for a while. You know, I tried to take it easy. I was like, alright, well, maybe I need to work on my cardio. Started running some more. Then it started happening again. Started getting that pain back. Then I decided, hey, well, I can't run anymore. Maybe I should lift weights. Tried to lift weights, and it came back every time I lifted weights. So I was like, damn, well, I need to take it easy then. Take a break. So 1, 2, 3 years passed, and now I'm like 5 years. 5 years haven't been contesting, haven't been around the powwow trail. Like, I ghosted the powwow trail. Haven't talked to any of my powwow friends. I don't know what they. Yeah, I don't think they even know where I'm at. That's how crazy it is. But lately, I've been running, losing weight, and I noticed me doing cardio. Since we're in this high altitude, like we're at 71,000 feet here in Santa Fe, Mexico. So, but I'm trying to get back, and I know I had designed 2 outfits, and I want to try to make those reality, make them real, make them not as an ideal, but make them. So I want to try to come out this summer again, maybe hit the power trails, but we'll see how it goes. But back to the moral of the story is that you need to take it easy. So all that came within, all that feeling, all that emotions, all that experience came from that post that I read. So that hit me really hard that day. That post, that was a good poll, I'm not gonna lie. So back to moral story, you know, take it easy. If not, you're gonna injure yourself, and mentally, physically, you're gonna hurt yourself. And I'm the type of person that kept on pushing and pushing and pushing, and I'm starting to learn that you need to take a break. It does not mean you're giving up. It's not meaning that you're quitting. It's mean like you need time to focus on your health. And that's what I've been doing. So, yeah. So you guys, take it easy. Take a break. Come back to it. You get frustrated? Hey, live and learn, yo. I hope it's breakfast time now. I'm kind of hungry. Get some yogurt and some fruit. Scrambled eggs. Yeah. All right. Let's go see if breakfast's ready. So, getting ready to go get some breakfast, but there's a song I've been listening to, and it's just just like so good. It reminds me back at Haskell, my homeboy, Damon DeMundo Rico. He always played this, and when we used to hang out in my room, my dorm room, he used to blast this a lot. And my friend Damon and my other friend, they all used to start dancing, and I was like, oh, and we all just like start dancing, just getting crazy. But this is the song. Yeah.
full. That fruit and the strawberries was amazing. Oh.